Hello friend and welcome back. Once again, I'm here to show you some 20 practice questions of Business Regulatory Framework of TYBCon. So friends, please allow me to share my screen. Here I'm sharing my screen. I think it is visible now. Friends, once again, I welcome you all to my official YouTube channel, that is Academic Insight. This is my channel. I request you all to subscribe my channel without fail and don't forget to press bell icon so that we can have such kind of videos in days to come. Also like my videos, share my videos with your friends, colleagues and relatives. Also go for writing your comments in chat box. So this is for my basic. Now once again we are here for basic question, basic MCQ question, that is multiple choice questions of Business Regulatory Framework, Class TYBCon, Semester 5. Again, we are taking 20 more questions here, but the topic is different. We are talking about the topic of Law of Partnership. We are going to see what sort of questions can be asked on this particular topic in the form of MCQ, multiple choice questions. So question number one, under Section 2, Subsection B, of the Indian Partnership Act, business includes. So what business, under the concept of business, what includes according to Section 2, Subsection B of Indian Partnership Act? So here there are four options, and out of those four options, you guys have to choose one option as a correct option. Every trade and occupation, every occupation and profession, every trade, occupation and profession, every trade and profession. So these are the four options, and you guys have to choose one correct option for this question number one. And the correct option is every trade, occupation and profession. Moving on to the second question, and the second question is, under Section 2B of Indian Partnership Act, business include. Already we have seen this one. Already we have seen this one. We are going to see the next one. Under Section 2B of Indian Partnership Act, business include. The options are, partner is an agent of the firm, partner is owner of the firm, partner is director of the firm, none of the above. And the correct option is, partner is an agent of the firm. Next, question number three, what is partnership at will? This one is the question. What is partnership at will? And the option are, created under a will by testator, created by consent of all the partners, partnership without provision for duration. And the question number, the option number next, that is last one, none of the above. And the correct option is, partnership without provision of duration. This kind of partnership is called as partnership at will. Question number four, a partnership not for any fixed duration is called as what? A partnership not for any fixed duration. The partnership which is not there for a fixed duration or for a specific duration, what do we call it? Partnership at will, indissoluble partnership, either A or B, means partnership at will, or in indissoluble partnership, number D, none of the above. And the correct option is, partnership at will. Which of the following is a strong but not sufficient test of partnership? And the options are, sharing of profits, sharing of losses, either of the two, none of the above. And the correct option is, sharing of profits. Question number six, a partnership firm is. The options are, a distinct legal entity from its partner, not a distinct legal entity from its partner, a juristic person, none of the above. And the correct option is, not a distinct legal entity from its partner is the correct option. Question number seven, a partner can retire by notice of intention to retire, where a partner can retire by notice of intention to retire, where the options are, the partner is at will, the partner is for a specific period, where a contract has been made between the partners for it, and the last one, none of the above. And the correct option is, the partner is at will, or the partnership is at will, is the right option. Question number eight, As per Section 5 of the Indian Partnership Act, the relationship of partnership is created by, how it is created? By status, by contract, by statute, or none of the above. And the correct option is it can be created by contract. Number 9, partnership means, the options are joint venture. Next, agreement between the person to share the profit of a business carried on between them. Agreement between the person to do some work, none of the above. So the correct option for this partnership meaning is agreement between the persons to share the profits of a business carried on the same, carried on them. The next question, that is question number 10. The relationship of partnership according to Section 5 of the Indian Partnership Act 1932 arises from, and the options are status, contract, friendship, and none of the above. And the correct option is contract. Question number 11, a limited liability partnership is, what does it mean, limited liability partnership? That is LLP, not a separate entity from that of its partners, a legal entity separate from that of its partners, a body corporate, and the last one, only B and C are correct. And the correct option is only B and C are correct. Number 12, a LLP shall be governed by the provisions of what? The Companies Act 2013, the Limited Liability Partnership Act 2008, the Cooperative Societies Act 1912, and the Indian Partnerships Act 1932, which act is applicable for LLP. The act which is applicable to LLP is the Limited Liability Partnership Act 2008. Question number 13, whether a HUF can become partner in LLP? The options are HUF may become partner of LLP provided the registrar may grant permission in this behalf. No, HUF can't become partner in LLP. Yes, HUF may become partner of LLP, none of the above. So these are the options, and out of those, B is the correct one. How many designated partners are required in LLP? So this one is talking about the limitation of partners in LLP. At least 2 designated partners, 7 designated partners, 2 designated partners, at least 7 designated partners. So the option is at least 2 designated partners are required to go for LLP. Then 15, question number 15, the LLP shall file the statement of accounts and solvency in the prescribed form. Which is this form? So which form is that for solvency of accounts, statement of accounts and solvency? The form number 8, form 7, form 6, Form 5, and the correct answer is Form 8. Question number 16, who is the authority to grant compounding of offense under the LLP Act? The options are the registrar of the firm, the central government, the registrar of cooperatives. The correct option is the central government. Question number 17, what is the time limit within which LLP shall file annual return with the registrar? And the options are within 30 days of closure, within 45 days of closure, within 60 days of closure, within 15 days of closure. So what is the correct answer? And the correct answer is within 60 days of closure of its financial year. Question number 18, at which place the LLP shall maintain books of accounts? And the options are at its branch office, at its corporate office, at its head office, and at its registered office. And the correct option is at its registered office. Question number 19, the statement of account and solvency is required to be filed by the LLP with, the options are the registrar of cooperative societies need not to file, the registrar of firms, and the correct option is the registrar. Question number 19, and this could be the last one, the books of accounts which LLP is required to keep shall be preserved for how many years? And the options are 8 years, 6 years, 4 years, and 2 years. The option is 8 years. Those should be preserved for 8 years. That is expected. Here, all the questions are over of this video. I hope you all have understood questions with answers. If you really like it, then please subscribe my channel. Even you also don't forget to press bell icon so that you'll get videos in future. Also like the video. Also share the video with your friends, colleagues and relatives, and don't forget to write your comment at the last. So only this much for today's two videos. I hope you guys have understood everything, and all the best for your exam. Thank you so much. It's time to take a break. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.